Hello, it just came to my attention a little while ago that St. Photios Orthodox Theological Seminary has a YouTube channel now, and there are a few things I want to say about this group. I'll get to Bishop Maximus in a moment. Well, this seminary is not Orthodox. It's not recognized by the Eastern Orthodox Church. These people are actually Old Calendarist schismatics. They used to go by the name Synod in Resistance. I don't know what they call themselves now, but several years ago they went into communion with the GOC HOCNA group. So they're not Orthodox. Okay, that's the first thing you should know. Now there's a lecture on that channel with Bishop Maximus Marretta. He used to be Father Maximus of Holy Ascension Monastery in New York. And I did a little investigation, and he is now the abbot of the Hermitage of St. Ignatius in Guatemala. And this is one thing I notice about Old Calendarists. They're always moving around. So formerly he was at Holy Ascension Monastery in New York. Now he's abbot in Guatemala. And Father Savas, GOC, was for a time at the Holy Ascension Monastery in New York. Then he served as priest in Florida for a while. Then he went to Canada to serve as priest. And I'm assuming he's still there. I don't know. I haven't checked into that. But I noticed that this Maximus is now Bishop Maximus. Bishop Maximus Marretta. Okay. So there are some things I want to say about this person. I met him many years ago. And I just want to share some things that happened. I've already exposed him on this channel. He told me in person that Bishop Christodoulos of the GOC is not regarded highly in the GOC. That's something you should know. So he basically insulted this bishop, and I don't know what canon it is. There's a canon which says that a priest who insults a bishop is to be deposed. And sorry, I just don't remember which canon that is. I read all the canons several years ago. So I want to know why this man was not deposed. See, this is another example of how Old Calendarists will violate the canons when and if it suits their purpose. Also, I want to bring to your attention that it was Father Maximus in person who related to me the fact that Bishop Christodoulos hit a homeless man in the face with a shovel. The GOC was sued for this, and the GOC settled out of court. And I've talked about this a lot on this channel. There is a canon, Apostolic Canon 27, which says that a clergyman who hits a person is to be deposed. How much more so for using something like a shovel? Another example of violation, if it suits their purpose. So it was Maximus who told me this. It really did happen. It's not a slander or anything. I also want to share with you that many years ago, when I was an Old Calendarist and interested in monasticism, I looked up to Father Maximus. I trusted him, and I feel betrayed by him, because there was a time where I was in regular email correspondence with him, and one time I clarified previous confessional sins so there would be no misunderstanding, and then one day Bishop Christodoulos emailed me from Father Maximus's email account, said it was an accident and that he meant to email me from his own account. This tells me there was no privacy, and Maximus never told me that Christodoulos had access to his email account. So I was really offended by this. You know, I trusted Father Maximus, and Bishop Christodoulos is one of the last people in the GOC that I would want having access to my personal email. I emailed Father Maximus asking for an explanation for this. Never heard back from him again. Never heard from him again, ever. See, he did not respect me enough to explain anything. It's possible he was given in obedience not to communicate with me. But this is a good example of a cultic characteristic. There's no dialogue. See, when you question them on things, they just retreat. They just want uncritical fans who will bow before them and praise everything they do, even when they violate Christian and church teaching. And I feel betrayed by Maximus for this. And like I said, it's possible he was given an obedience not to communicate with me. So there was no confidentiality, no privacy. He never made it known to me that there was no privacy or confidentiality. And this is the kind of thing you see in a cult. I'm not saying the GOC is a cult, but this is the kind of thing you would see in a cult. Okay. And also, it was Father Maximus who I reported Bishop Sirtis Black to. Bishop Sirtis Black, many years ago, pushed me away from his church for obedience to their 2002 encyclical, not disobedience. When he learned that I was against their clergy violating that encyclical, which says that non-GOC members who receive communion in GOC parishes do so to their own condemnation, he pushed me away. He did the exact opposite of what a Christian pastor should have done. I reported this to Father Maximus, and Father Maximus is the one who said that Bishop Sirtis will have to answer to God for what he did to me. Okay? So this is Bishop Maximus. I'm going to recommend some resources below in the description box on the dangers, the unsafe, unhealthy religious groups and leaders, and I recommend that you read Combating Cult Mind Control by Stephen Hassan, and that book was endorsed by Father Alexei Young, now Father Ambrose Young. Okay, so these groups do not always behave in the most honest and ethical manner. They just seem like they're so arrogant, they think they can do anything they want. People, you need to understand, this is serious. Their 2002 encyclical categorically prohibits their clergy communion new calendarists. And the reason is because those people receive communion to their own condemnation. Well, don't they believe that? If they don't believe it, then they shouldn't be in the GOC. If they do believe it and they're doing it anyway, this would mean they're evil. So all I did was protest this. And Father Maximus even told me on the phone one time that most of their people are against their clergy communion heretics. People perceived to be heretics from the GOC perspective. So I did them no wrong. They wrote the book, I read it. And I was pushed away by Bishop Sirtis for my obedience. The reason Bishop Sirtis himself gave, and I still have the email, he said, since I'm against their clergy giving communion to heretics, it would not be good for me to be in a church I believe to be heretical. I told that to Father Maximus, and he said that was false. He said most of their people are against their clergy giving communion to heretics. Father Maximus is the one who said that. And also, I never said that I believe the GOC was heretical at that time. I just simply wanted them to be obedient to their 2002 encyclical. They're hypocrites. And I don't know how true it is, but a zealot monk on Mount Athos wrote me several years ago and told me that the GOC was communing new calendarists 90% of the time in America and 100% of the time in Greece. So, you know, I'm not a bad person for telling the truth here. This is who these people are. They're hypocrites. They're disobedient. And I think it was Metropolitan Ephraim of HOCNA, now deceased, who told me that the GOC says one thing and does another. And it was Bishop Stefan of the RTOC who told me that this is one of the reasons why he didn't want to go into communion with them, because they communed new calendarists. So I told the truth. This is who these people are. And, you know, Father Maximus suggested that I move to New York, closer to the monastery. I was interested in monasticism at that time. But I explained before why I couldn't at that time. Okay, and one of the reasons I didn't want to is because I was watching them. I had a feeling they were going to unite with the Senin resistance. And that's exactly what happened. I predicted it was going to happen, and it happened. Oh, and by the way, Vladimir Moss once told me that if I was in the monastery, if I was in a GOC monastery, and I witnessed one of their priests communing a new calendarist to leave the monastery. That's how serious this is to Vladimir Moss. And Father Maximus responded to that and said that the devil will arrange it to get me out of the monastery. See? So, anyway, even though Father Maximus, you know, wanted me to relocate there to New York, I just feel betrayed by him. He was not completely supportive. It's possible he was given in obedience to cease supporting me by Christodoulos. Okay, but it's really depressing when you look up to a priest, you know, you trust him, and then he betrays you. He renounces you. He walks away for doing nothing other than being true to the book. These people wrote the book and I read it. I don't understand their mind frame. I don't understand how they can claim to be Christians. I don't understand how they can go to communion. This is betrayal. See, I was always true to Orthodoxy. I was always true to these old calendarists. And once the clergy realized I wasn't going to tolerate their disobedience and hypocrisy, they dropped me like a hot potato. This is Eastern Orthodoxy, people. Actually, it's the old calendarists. But there's a lot of problems with mainstream Eastern Orthodoxy as well. And one thing you need to know about these people immediately, they are so of bad will. You cannot reason with them. They do not care about your perspective and the fact that all the facts and truth are on your side. They have an agenda. They have an agenda. And they were probably told that there would be conservative type people like me. And they just want to release you. They just want to get rid of you. Once they realize you're not going to tolerate, you know, their disobedience and hypocrisy. So they created all the problems and I just responded to them. See, I mean, they put such harsh rules on people. I was taught that I could not go to any mainstream parish back at that time. You know, I follow the rules, and yet there's so much hypocrisy among them. If I can't go to any mainstream parish, then what were they doing communing people belonging to mainstream parishes? Notice the contradiction and inconsistency here. This is what you're going to see with false religions and false churches. So anyway, Father Maximus, now Bishop Maximus, you know, he just was not supportive enough and he betrayed me. And like I said, you know, I'm going to cut him some slack here because he probably was given an obedience not to support me. He started out good. But once Bishop Christodoulos and I think the bishops of the GOC recognized I wasn't going to tolerate their disobedience, once they recognized this, they just dropped me off the side of the road like I never existed. You know, went on their merry way, going to communion like nothing's wrong, just living their lives. This is how these kind of people are. So I categorically affirm to you what I said here is the absolute truth about this Bishop Maximus. I want to add a couple points here. You need to understand that a mind that is damaged, that is thinking in cult categories, will flip the situation and reinterpret it. And also, I think that the GOC over the last several years has been unhappy about my video critiques of them. But they need to understand they created the problem. They created the problem. This is who they are. So they have no one to blame but themselves. If they had dealt with Bishop Jerjis in an honest, ethical, Christian way, you know, had I been assured that there was accountability and justice, I probably wouldn't have made all these video critiques, but they never assured me that there was any kind of accountability. And I think the reason is because they're just too arrogant to, one, acknowledge the videos, and two, to acknowledge on an official level that one of their bishops did something wrong. So this is a problem with the old calendars, not only the old calendars, but with Eastern Orthodox leadership as well. These people are in possession of profound spiritual teachings, but ironically, it's like they are among the most prideful and arrogant people you could come across. in religion. When they become bishops and clergy, they get so full of themselves. Where is the humility in these people? And this Bishop Sergius Black character, I cannot believe this man, that he is actually an abbot of a monastery. He's guiding souls. He knows that he was wrong for pushing me away from his monastery for obedience to their 2002 encyclical. And yet he goes to communion. He's living in a monastery. He's claiming to be a Christian. I don't know how someone like this faces himself every day, how he lives with himself. In a nutshell, I don't know what planet these people are from, people like this. Why are they even in monasteries when they're obviously not serious about spiritual advancement? Sorry, I have kind of a minor cough right now. Sometimes I just think in astonishment, is this real? Is this real? These people who present this facade of so much piety are so wicked in their hearts. It's astonishing. It's like just a show, like they're pretending. They're pretenders. So I'll give more information below in the description box. And I think that probably Father Maximus was given in obedience not to assist me. There's no dialogue. They retreat when they get caught. And this is the kind of thing you see in a cult. A few more words before I end this video. I think that the GOC is not happy with my video critiques, and that may be why they have behaved this way. But they need to understand that they created the problem, and I was never assured that there was any accountability with Bishop Sergius Black. And also, you folks need to understand that there's more to Christianity than being super correct in doctrine and having a super correct ecclesiology. You also have to be warm, loving, compassionate. You need to have empathy, and you need to be honest and ethical. And you do not strike me as the most warm, honest, and ethical people in the world. And finally, Bishop Maximus, I want to ask you, why did you reveal my confessional sin? I clarified confessional sin to you. You never made it known to me that Bishop Christodoulos had access to my emails and to your email account. You allow that man to have access to my personal, private information. There are consequences to actions. Don't you realize how hurtful and scandalous this is? I trusted you. I trusted you. Again, there are consequences to actions. People need to know that they can look up to priests. That priests aren't going to go around revealing confessional sins and personal information. So, I lost all respect for you after this. And I'll end this video now.